word for you.
What is it?
This may be worthwhile. Nothing to report, sir.
That may be worth investigating. That tower is impressive, even as a ruin. I wonder what dreams it might hold.
Mother Giselle should be somewhere nearby.
Inquisition forces. They're trying to protect the refugees.
Looks like they could use a hand.
Hold. We are not apostates.
I do not think they care, Seeker. Be ready. More coming our way.
done.
There are mages here who can heal your wounds. Lie still.
Don't touch me, Mother. Their magic is...
Turn to noble purpose. Their magic is surely no more evil than your blade.
What?
Hush, dear boy. Allow them to ease your suffering.
Mother Giselle.
I am. And you must be the one they are calling the Herald of Andraste.
I'm told you asked for me.
I know of the Chantry's denouncement, and I am familiar with those behind it. I won't lie to you. Some of them are grandstanding, hoping to increase their chances of becoming the new divine. Some are simply terrified. So many good people, senselessly taken from us.
What happened was horrible.
Fear makes us desperate, but hopefully not beyond reason. Go to them. Convince the remaining clerics you are no demon to be feared. They have heard only frightful tales of you. Give them something else to believe.
They want to execute me, and you think I should just walk up to them?
You are no longer alone. They cannot imprison or attack you.
They could try.
Let me put it this way. You needn't convince them all. You just need some of them to doubt. Their power is the unified voice. Take that from them and you receive the time you need.
So I show up, say hello, show them the mark on my hand.
I honestly don't know if you've been touched by fate or sent to help us, but I hope. Hope is what we need now. The people will listen to your rallying call as they will listen to no other. You could build the Inquisition into a force that will deliver us, or destroy us. I will go to Haven and provide Sister Leliana the names of those in the Chantry who will be amenable to a gathering. It is not much, but I will do whatever I can.
Corporal Vale is coordinating the Inquisition's efforts in the area. We should speak with him.
Thank you.
hear it.
Good day.
That's the last of the bread. Going to be a long, hungry night.
These people need food.
There are rams out in the hills. Good eating, cooks easy, and no lords around to kill you for poaching. Too dangerous to go hunting now, though. More likely to find mages than muttons.
Good luck.
Luck won't put fat on your ribs.
My wife. Please, I beg you.
What's wrong with your wife?
She gets sick when the weather's foul. Can't catch her breath, like cobwebs in her lungs. Our son Hindle makes a potion that lets her breathe. He's the only one who can make it, but he's joined that cult in the hills. Please, get to him and tell him what's wrong. Without that potion, she'll die.
Of course.
It's good to have commerce restored. I've many goods here if you wish to trade.
Could be better.
I have heard stories about you, Herald of Andraste. I am Enchanter Elendra. I hope you find a way to end this foolish war.
If you're a mage, why aren't you with the rebel mages?
I was an enchanter in the College of Equitarians. We wanted tolerance, not war. By rights, I am sworn to join the rebels. But I had friends among the Templars. I will not fight them. I know my own strength. I have no fear of demons. I will keep to myself and harm none.
Farewell.
Good day. Greetings.
If you're a mage, why aren't you with the rebel mages?
I was an enchanter in the
College of Equitarians. We wanted tolerance, not war. By rights, I am sworn to join the rebels. But I had friends among the Templars. I will not fight them. I know my own strength. I have no fear of demons. I will keep to myself and harm none.
Farewell.
Good day.
What do you need to keep these refugees warm?
Blankets, warm clothes, all of it. These poor sods lost everything when the mages and the Templars went crazy. If we were in a village, I could just pinch a blanket off a clothesline and be fine. Out here, I'm sure the apostates have plenty of supplies, just haven't been able to find them.
Farewell.
And see you.
Have gone mad with power.
The Templars aren't looking any better here.
Back me up. Kill that warrior.
We should move on. We can only restore order by securing an alliance.
Thank you. I've wondered, how did you know to approach us, Solas? The breach opened, we were scrambling and barely had time to think. And there you were.
I went to see the breach for myself. I did not know you would be there.
You must not have been far away.
I was not. I'd come to hear of the Conclave, but did not want to get close.
Lucky for us, then.
Thank you.
Hopefully the Inquisition can find some way to help these people.
Maker's breath. If I were back in the city, I could just steal some blankets.
What do you need to keep these refugees warm?
Blankets, warm clothes, all of it. These poor sods lost everything.
Goodbye.
If you say so.
Would that I could.
Right. That's why.
If you say so.
Mages, Templars, bandits, demons. Making it hard for a man to hunt for his supper.
Good luck.
Luck won't put fat on your ribs.
Good day.
May God be with you.
Something like that.
Is there anything we can do? Just ask.
Humanade has notes on alloys that may prove more effective against demons.
Oh, does she? Well, we'll take anything that gives our blades a bit more bite. You mages aren't half bad.
I am no longer a mage.
Even better. Another time, then. That'll do.
I hope that wasn't meant to be me.
What? That?
You obviously don't like somebody.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool, and they may be right.
What does your faith tell you?
I believe you are innocent. I believe more is going on here than we can see. And I believe no one else cares to do anything about it. They will stand in the fire and complain that it is hot. But is this the Maker's will? I can only guess.
What's going to happen now?
Now, we deal with the Chantry's panic over you before they do even more harm. Then we close the breach. We are the only ones who can. After that, we find out who is responsible for this chaos, and we end them. And if there are consequences to be paid for what I have done, I pay them. I only pray the price is not too high.
Isn't it a bit late to worry about it now?
We have only just begun. My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
I can't say I'm not grateful to hear that.
I can be harsh, I know. I'm curious. Do you even believe in the Maker?
You're asking a dwarf?
You're a surface dwarf. I've known some, like Varric, who, I suppose, it doesn't matter now. I have to believe we were put on this path for a reason, even if you do not. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us.
Still got demons pouring out of the rifts. Existed was silence. Then the voice of the Maker rang out, the first word, and his word became all that might be.
You're worried about the rift. I understand that.
I read your tale of the champion, and I have a few questions.
That's a pretty common reaction. Go ahead.
In the book, you say that first Enchanter Orsino turned himself into a giant monster made of corpses. How? Why?
Do I look like an expert on magical weirdness to you? Well, I can't tell you how. For the why, all I can say is he was desperate.
There's no way Hawk really could have killed the Arashok. It would have started a war with the Kunari.
I was told later that the Kunari disavowed his actions. Apparently, the Arashok didn't get permission before he attacked Kirkwall, and the Kuhn didn't want another exalted march. When they finally sent a ship to haul the wrecked dreadnought away, they just said, "We will never speak of this again." And as far as I can tell, that's the Kuhn's version of an apology.
Where are the rest of Hawk's associates now?
Meryl decided to look after the elves left homeless by the fighting. She's done a pretty good job of keeping them away from the mages and Templars, so far. I guess she has plenty of practice avoiding stupid human battles with her old Dalish clan. Isabella went back to the Raiders. She's calling herself an admiral now. I don't know if she's actually in charge or just has a really big hat. Might be the same thing, honestly. Sebastian went back to Starkhaven. I'm sure he's boring all sorts of people there. Hawk's little sister is in the Free Marches, helping some of the other survivors from the Kirkwall Circle. Aveline is still guard captain. I'm pretty sure Kirkwall would fall into the sea if she quit her job.
Are we going to have new verses in the Chant of Light?
What did I tell you?
Tell him what she did.
Oh, Maker, you're here. You're the Herald of Andraste. And you were sent to remind us that we failed to support the dwarves when the Darkspawn attacked. I think dwarves are very respectable, and I've always liked those. I'm Flissa. Can I get you a drink?
It's all right, Flissa. I won't do anything frightening.
If you wanted to close the breach, I wouldn't mind. As I said, I'm Flissa. The Inquisition soldiers needed a place to unwind, so Leliana brought me in to set up a tavern. Nothing fancy, but it's safer for the soldiers than looking for trouble in some village.
Enchanter, come to me. Enchanter, come to me. Enchanter, come to see. Can you come to see? As you once were blind, in the light now you can see. In our strength we can rely.
You said Leliana asked you to run an Inquisition tavern. How did you meet?
Some luck meeting. I managed the name back in Denim. When I heard interesting gossip, I passed word to Leliana. Sometimes it's helpful. She asked if I wanted to own my own tavern, and I said yes. I didn't realize she meant this.
Can you tell me about this area?
Adan is Haven's apothecary. He's been making potions and tending to the wounded as best he can. Harris is the Inquisition's smith. Whatever he can make you, Thren the quartermaster can probably find. And for anything fancier, you can try buying from Segrid. His prices aren't too high. Yes? Oh, there's also my knave. She studies beasts and things, as I understand.
Farewell.
Goodbye.
Closing the breach is our primary goal, but I hope we might also discover what was used to create it. Any artifact of such power is dangerous. The destruction of the Conclave proves that much.
You don't think whatever created the explosion was destroyed in the blast?
You survived, did you not? The artifact that created the breach is unlike anything seen in this age. I will not believe it destroyed until I see the shattered fragments with my own eyes.
We would do well to try to recover whatever created the breach.
Liliana's people have scoured the area near the blast and found nothing. Whatever the artifact was, it is no longer there. In any case, did you need me for anything?
What do you know about the Fade?
A great deal, from my wanderings. There are a few hard facts, but I can share what I have learned.
I'd like to know more about the Veil.
Circle mages call it a barrier between this world and the Fade. But according to my studies in ancient Elven lore, that is a vast oversimplification. Without it, imagine if spirits entered freely. The Fade was not a place one went, but a state of nature like the wind.
We've got enough trouble with demons already.
But would they still be demons? Or would they be part of a natural environment, like a fast-flowing river? Yes, it can drown careless children, but it can also carry a merchant's goods or grind a miller's flour. That is what the world could be if the Veil were not present. For better or worse.
I'd like to know more about demons.
The Chantry says that demons hate the natural world and seek to bring their chaos and destruction to the living. But such simplistic labels misconstrue their motivations, and in so doing, do all a great disservice. Spirits wish to join the living, and a demon is that wish gone wrong.
Is there a way to coexist? To live with them? If not in peace, at least without such active confrontation?
Not in the world we know today. The Veil creates a barrier that makes true understanding most unlikely. But the question is a good one, and it matters that you thought to ask.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Flissus!
You're back! And in one piece!
How are your people holding up?
We've got Mother Giselle lending a hand now, which helps. For the ones that need comforting more than actual healing, she's a rock in fast water. Something to cling to.
For a healer, you don't seem particularly nurturing.
I'm not a healer. I'm an alchemist who's forced to play Mother Hen. You want something to burst into flame on contact with the air? Done. Gladly. Patching up wounded soldiers is a waste of my time and talents. But there are a few around who can help.
Farewell.
There you go.